For the longest time, I've had a love-hate relationship with the develop module of On One Photo Raw. And guess what? All is good now, because camera profiles have been updated in the new version, On One Photo Raw 2024. They now support DCP files. What's that? Digital camera profiles. And I'm going to show you how to use them and how you can get your camera's profile downloaded for free. Okay, so this is the problem. If you look at the image on the left, that is the RAW file. Image on the right is JPEG, straight out of the camera. Why do I have both those? Again, going back to my love-hate relationship with On One, I've been shooting both RAW and JPEGs of all images and mostly relying on the JPEGs because they look so much better because the camera profile is baked into the JPEG. Instead of using On One's Photo RAW standard camera profile, which flattens out the image and makes the colors just not right. I mean, if we look at the skin tones, so muddy, so nothing like I saw it, nothing like the camera cyan color of the Canon RP that I used for this image. And what was even worse is, let's just go back here and let's change this so we hide the JPEG files. And now we see all RAW. And the problem was, you'd see a great looking image. You double click on it and it looks great. And then you go into develop and boom, all the color saturation went away. And that's because of the camera profiles. With the new version of 2024, you now have access to your camera profile. So you have the regular ones that were there, but now we have, it shows the camera, RP faithful. So right off the bat, it is looking so much better than what was there. Now, it's not going to match exactly to the JPEG because that's proprietary. What we're using is Adobe's camera profile for the Canon RP, but it is much, much better. And it gets me so much closer to the results that I want. And let me show you how you can make sure. If you go to the camera profiles and your camera isn't listed and you just have the normal ones, let me show you where you can get those downloaded for free. When you do this, it's going to add all the camera profiles. So just pick whether you have a Mac or a Windows computer. Once you install the software, it is going to add all those camera profiles. And if you want to find out where it installed all the camera profiles, it would be on your hard drive, under library, under application support, then Adobe, camera raw, camera profiles, and then a folder camera. And it's going to have all of these installed. Okay, so Nikon, Canon, Olympus, Panasonic, and Sony. Hopefully your camera is there as well. And all you'll have to do is, once you have those closed down On One Photo Raw 2024 and start it back up, and you'll have that in your develop tab. Fortunately, you cannot use those in any of the earlier versions. So if you have 2023, you're not going to be able to use these DCP files. So let's take a look at another image. This was using a Nikon, an older model, a D7500. We'll open it up in develop. Shortcut is the letter D on your keyboard. And again, did you see how the changed? The color looked good for a moment, and then it used the standard profile. And there's nothing wrong with the standard profile, but it is generic. They're trying to come up with a profile for all types of cameras. And you saw the list. There are so many different brands of cameras and models of cameras that a generic profile just isn't going to do justice. If we click on that, Now it doesn't show the RP profiles because that would be wrong. It shows all the ones for the Nikon D7500. So a flat profile, landscape, all the different ones. And for this, I really like the standard, but that is so much closer to her skin tone than what this was. Look at that compared to if we use a proper camera profile, right? May take that down just a touch. That is a fantastic looking skin tone. So much better than the default profile, the generic profile. Also, if you'd like to see a tutorial on retouching, leave a comment below. I'd love to share some tips getting professional results retouching using On One Photo Raw. Check mark, we're done. And again, let's just compare two different images. And what a huge difference from using a proper camera profile on the left compared to the generic On One standard camera profile on the right. Again, back in love with On One Photo Raw. Hope this is helpful. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe. Share it with your friends. That would be a huge help for this channel. If you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, be sure to leave a comment. Thanks so much. Until next time, keep shooting.